Hello students, hope you observe last video very carefully till the end. Here we are going to discuss about problems based on algebraic expression. In last video we discussed some two or three questions based on algebraic expression. In this video we completely discuss about different type of problems given in your book and how to solve it. So let's start. Next problem is if a statement is given to you and your question asked you to write down that sentence into algebraic form. How? Let's discuss. Suppose very simple question. If it is given that 7 is added to variable p. 7 is added to variable p. So how we write? It's a 7 plus p or p plus 7. Remember the statement, 7 is added to p, means p is there, and then after we are going to add 7. 7 is the secondary part. So it's a p plus 7. If it is given to you, same statement is there, but I change the operation. 7 is subtracted. From P. No? So as we did in this case, P plus 7 means what? Here we add 7 to P. So P must be at first place. 7 is subtracted from P. Subtracted from P means P is the bigger one, and we are going to reduce 7 from this P. So from P must be at first place, then subtract is subtraction sign, minus 7 likewise, and need not to forget use brackets. Clear? It's a P minus 7. If we change the statement and the same thing written in this form, P is subtracted from 7, then how we solve this one? We can solve from 7 means what? 7 is a bigger one. We are going to write 7 at first, then subtracted which thing? P. So it's a minus P. Clear? It's a minus P. 7 minus P. Use bracket. So likewise, you have to solve. Remember about this word. From. 7 is subtracted from P. Means P is bigger one. P must come at the first place. From 7. 7 must come at first place. Let's see some more statement. Okay, good one I have found. 7 is subtracted from minus m. 7 is subtracted from minus m. So how we return, as I discussed with you, this must be bigger one, though we don't care about minus sign or plus sign. Whatever written after from, that come must at the first place. So minus m, and which thing is subtracted? 7. So what we use? Minus subtraction sign for this one. This is your first place. This is given to you. This come at first place. Minus m. then 7 is subtracted, so we use the subtraction sign and this one, so use bracket. So need not to confuse, number variable may change, but you have to remember all the concept what I discussed in the video. Now move to some new statement. As we know, 7 times of p, 7 times of, in this case, x, 7 times of x means what? 7 into x or 7x. Or if we use 7 multiplied from x, 7x. So this is a, these are a very simple statement. Though if it is given that if I change the statement, minus 7 multiplied by a, then what happened? Minus 7 into a, minus 7, no sign is there in between number and literal, so it's a 7 into a. Hope this one is clear to you. Minus, always remember 7, minus 7, not 7, minus 7 in a. Similarly, we use this for division purpose. Change this number. 5 is divided by x. 5 is divided by x. What does it signify? 5 divided by x. Either this one, or you can write likewise in fraction form, 5 upon x. 5 divided by x. Clear? This is the first thing. Hope this one is clear to you. If I say no, x is divided by 5. If I said x is divided by 5, it's a x divided by 5, it's a x upon 5, x divided by 5, x divided by 5. Similarly, we change the sign, and if we use minus sign, then you must use bracket, because two different sign or two sign not come together. It needs at least one separator, maybe number, maybe bracket. Clear? So these are the statement you have to express into algebraic form. Now move to some more complex type of statement. Some more complex, in which we have some complex expressions. For example, if 10 is added to 2x, this means 2x, no? Added to 2x. It's very simple. 2x already given to you plus 10. Need not to confuse. Similarly, if it says 7 is subtracted, no. If it's given that 10 is subtracted, no, minus 10 is subtracted from 3y, minus 10 is subtracted from 3y. So how we write? First we write this must be come at first, 3y, then subtraction is there, we use minus sign, then second term is minus 10, so we write minus 10, but remember within bracket. Now this is not a complete one. In this case, you have to remove the bracket. So when we remove bracket, what we have 3y. If you remove the bracket, so minus minus sign changes, it's a plus 10, use bracket, so it's a 3y plus 10. This one is for this one, minus 10 is subtracted from 3y. Hope this thing is clear to you. Now next, some statement, some more complex statement. This one, 3 is added to 5 times of y. In this case, how we written? First, 5 times of y. What does it mean? 5 into y. 5 times of y means what? 5 into y. And what is added or subtracted? Here we have added which one? 3. 5y plus 3. Use bracket. And if it is written that 7, 3 is subtracted from this one, so then we have to change the sign. This one, y is multiplied to minus x. Y is, no, not minus x, use the word thing, number first, minus 3. Y is multiplied to minus 3 and 5 is added to result. Y is multiplied to minus 3. First do this thing. It's a minus 3 into y. And 5 is added plus 5. So minus 3y plus 5, use bracket. Clear? So likewise you have to solve. If it is given that 5 is subtracted, then we use minus 5 in place of plus 5. Hope this concept is clear to you. Move to some more complex type problems. As you are observing on the board, it is given that 6 more than thrice a number. This part is a little bit shiny, as you know, so please adjust it. 6 more than thrice a number x. How we write here? 6 more means what? We have to add. 6 more means we have to add the 6 in the result. Which result? Thrice a number of x. Thrice a number means what? 3 into x. Thrice a number. And 6 more. Clear? It's a 3x plus 6. Use bracket. If it's given that 6 less than thrice a number, then what? Then we do the subtraction over here. If it's given that 6 less in place of more, then we use minus sign. One more. If it is given that 3 less than quotient of x by y, what does this second part mean? Quotient of x by y means what? We have to divide. When we found the quotient, when we divide these two, then only find the quotient. So do this one, x by y, 3 less, so subtract minus 3. Hope these things clear to you. Complete all the expressions. Statement of expressions given in your book. Now move to the next part. Yes, now something about variables and numbers given to you, and we discuss about, we do write down in expression form. See how. In this example, listen my voice very carefully. In this example, it is given that form six expressions. It is written over there. Form expressions using y, 2 and 7 use only two different number operations, and every expression must have y in it. Means what? We have to use y, 2 and 7. We have to use y, 2 and 7 and two different operations means and then y must in it. These things given to us means we have to write form some expressions by using y, 2 and 7. We must use two different operations, and y must present in every operation. Y must present in every operations. So how we solve? Let's start. First, we need y, 2 and 7, we need y, always we need y in any form. So first, 2 plus 7 minus y. This is your first expression. We must solve it. It's a 9 minus y first. Then second, 2 minus 2 plus 7. Two different operations are there. We simply change the number. What we have? Y plus 5. No? Minus 2 plus 7 is a y plus 5. Then we must use division also. Your third expression must be divide. 2 divided by y plus 7. According to Bodmas, we know 2 upon y plus 7. Reverse, we can change, or we can do this thing. 2 into y divided by 7 means what? 2y divided by 7. So likewise, you can form more and more expressions by using two different signs and y present in every expressions. If you have to read the statement very carefully, then form the expressions. Now move to the next questions. In this, these are known as your mark type problem. In this case, it is given that teacher, a boy scored X marks in English. In English subject, scored X marks. Clear? Scored X marks. But teacher reduced 5 marks for bad handwriting. So what is the total marks? Or new marks? Equals to first he scored X marks. Reduction means what? Reduction means we have to subtract minus 5. This is the new marks. This is the easiest one. Move to the next question. Let me rub the board. This is known as your age problem. So now see here, over here, I am reading as well as I must write some key points of the questions on board. You must see here. Raju's father age is 2 years more than 3 times Raju's age. Three times Raju's age. If Raju's present age is Y year, Raju's present is your Y years, then what is his father's age? Very easy. Raju's age is Y year. Statement says that father's age is 3 times more than Raju's age. So therefore, father's age equals to 3 times than Raju's age. So 3 into Y. Here. Clear? This is your Raju's age. Hope this one is clear to you. Move to the next part. And all of you see very carefully what I am reading, what I am writing. See carefully. Solve those problems by yourself in your rough copy and just try to find if I did any mistake, if I make any mistake or not. This question explains you better one, the age problems. So I am reading, listen carefully. Mohini's age is X. Mohini is X year old. So what is Mohini's age? X year. Clear? Express the following algebraical form. Means you write down the expression. Statement is given to you. 3 times Mohini's age next year. 3 times Mohini's age next year. What does it mean? One by one statement. Okay, see the statement very carefully. Yes, now see the statement very carefully. 3 times Mohini's age next year. Means, what is the Mohini's age next year? And it's, so next year, Mohini's age is X plus 1. We must add 1. Clear? And it's 3 times. So, it is 3. 3 into X plus 1. Hope this one is clear. Mohini's age next year. What is the Mohini's age next year? Present year is X. Present is X year. Next year, one more. X plus, we have to add 1. X plus 1. Then 3 times. 3 into X plus 1. Next one is फोर टाइम्स मोनी सेज थ्री ईयर अगो मीन्स थ्री ईयर बैक. सो वी हैव टू सब्ट्रैक्ट थ्री फ्रॉम प्रेजेंट ईयर देन डू दिस वन. सो वाई माइनस थ्री इंटू फोर. फोर टाइम्स मोनी इज थ्री ईयर्स अगो. नाउ दीज आर द सम इजिएस्ट पार्ट. लिटिल बिट टफेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस इज दिस वन. लेट मी नॉट द बोर्ड. द प्रेजेंट एज ऑफ मोहिनी's अंकल इफ हिज अंकल इज फाइव टाइम्स एज ओल्ड एज मोहिनी विल बी टू ईयर फ्रॉम नाउ. Now, it says that present age of Mohini's uncle, if his uncle is five times as old as Mohini will be 2 years from now. So from now means after 2 years. So it's a what? Sorry. It's a x plus 2 clear and 5 times this one 5x plus 2. Hope this one is clear to you. Similarly, you can write the fourth question also. Fourth statement says the present age of Moni's cousin, if her cousin is 2 years less, cousin is 2 years less, cousin is 2 years less than one third of Moni's is 5 years ago. So what is the Moni's age 5 years ago? It's a x minus 5, this one. And cousin is 2 years less than one third of Moni's age. So one third of Moni's age 5 years ago minus 2. So this is the cousin's age. Hope now you can easily understand. I'm not going to explain the last statement, how we do this. Do it by yourself. Now, hope you can easily understand all those problems. Now, all of you try to solve all these questions by yourself and complete your exercise 9.3. Complete exercise 9.3 now by yourself. That's all for today. Thank you.